بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين، واللعن الدائم على أعدائه مجمعين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين. Dear viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. As you remember, we were talking in our previous session about humbleness. We gave a very brief definition of the term humbleness, and then we talked about the importance of this moral quality. We pointed out that humbleness is one of the qualities of believers. Believers, being believers, are required to acquire this quality and to get this attribute. And if a believer is not qualified with this quality, we cannot call him a believer, and he lacks some main qualities that are supposed to be achieved by believers. We also pointed out that humbleness is something that is based on a correct self-understanding. If you have a correct understanding of your personality, of yourself, if you know about your deficiencies, about your defects and flaws, and if you know that you are totally dependent on the power of Allah the Almighty, you will be automatically humble, and you will not have any reason to be arrogant and to show off. What we lack in is a correct self-understanding. And those who are proud, those who are arrogant, are lacking in self-understanding. If they improve their self-understanding, if they improve their understanding of their personality, of course, they will become humble and they will no longer be arrogant. Another important aspect of this quality is that it is a quality that is advised by Luqman. Luqman, being a very wise person, being a very intelligent person, advised his sons to be humble. And from his advice, we can understand that this quality is very important, because Luqman is not a simple person. He is not a person like an ordinary person. Rather, he was a very wise person and he knew different things. And he was very much experienced. Because of all this, his advice is very much important and we must deeply consider his advice. When he advises his son, he says, be humble, try to be humble, and don't be arrogant. So this shows that this quality is a very important quality. Let me quote a verse from the Holy Quran that reflects this advice of Luqman. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in his Holy Quran says, وَلَا تُسَعِرْ خَدَّكَ لِلنَّاسِ. Don't turn your face away from people in contempt. Of course, when you turn your face away from people, if you have a sound reason to do so, it is not bad. Do it. But if you turn your face away from people as a sign of contempt, as a sign of insult, then this is very bad. And try not to do it, because it is a sign of insulting others. And to insult others and to look at others contemptuously is not good. وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا. And then the Holy Prophet says, لَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا. Don't walk on earth proudly. Don't be arrogant. If you are arrogant, your walk will show your state of mind, and you don't need to hide it. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ كُلَّ مُخْتَالٍ فَخُورٍ. Allah the Almighty does not love those who are proud and those who are self-conceited. وَقْصُدْ فِي مَشْيَكْ. Be moderate in your walking. When you walk, try to be moderate and try not to show off, because doing such kind of things is not good. وَقْزُزْ مِنْ سَوْتِكْ. And lower your voice. When you speak, do not speak loudly. Speak with a lower voice. إِنَّ أَنْكَرَ الْأَصْوَاتِ لَسَوْتُ الْحَمِيرِ. The most hateful of voices is the braying of asses or donkeys. So the Holy Quran compares the voice of an arrogant person to the braying of an ass. Just as the braying of an ass is very much hateful and is not liked by anyone, likewise, the voice of an arrogant person is bad and nobody likes it. So this advice is very important, and it can tell us about the importance of this quality. Let me quote a story from the life of the Holy Prophet that tells us something about this moral quality. Once there were some people in a specific area, there was a crowd. The Holy Prophet asked, why have they gathered there? What is the reason? Somebody told the Holy Prophet that there is a mad person, there is an insane person, and the crowd has gathered there in order to look at him, in order to laugh at him. The Holy Prophet then made a remark, and his remark is very much important. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, said that let me introduce a mad person to you. And do you want to hear the qualities of a mad person from me? The people that were there said unanimously that they were interested in hearing the qualities of a real mad person. The Holy Prophet said then, Al-Mutabakhtir fi mashihi. A mad person is as a person who walks very proudly. An-Nazir fi atfayh. A mad person looks at different sides. Time and again, he changes his look. He looks at different directions. Sometimes he looks at his right side, and sometimes he looks at his left side. So his look is not a balanced look. He looks at different things. Al-muharrik janbay, a mad person is a person who moves his shoulders time and again in order to show that he is well off, in order to show that he is stronger, and so on and so forth. Al-muharrik janbayhi bimin kabayhi, he moves his shoulders. Al-lazi la yurja khayruhu, a mad person is a person whom we cannot, in whom we do not have any faith, in whom we do not have any belief. We cannot be hopeful about him. A mad person is a person we are not hopeful about him. And it is not hoped that his condition will improve. Rather, his condition is likely to deteriorate. وَلَا يُؤْمَنْ شَرُّهُ, we are not sure that he will not harm others. It is very possible for him to harm others. He might steal the properties of others. He might break the windows. He might steal your cars. He might damage your property. And he might do whatever you may think or you may not think. So لَا يُؤْمَنْ شَرُّهُ فَذَلِكَ الْمَجْنُونَ, that person is the mad person. وَهَذَا مُبْتَلَى, and this is an ill person. So the Holy Prophet differentiated between a person who suffers from an illness and a person whose behavior is not correct. According to this saying of the Holy Prophet, a mad is a person whose behavior is not good, whose behavior is not up to the mark. But a person who is ill, he is ill. Everybody knows he is ill. And everybody must try to provide him assistance because he is an ill person. He is sick. He is suffering from some sort of illness. So attempts have to be made in order to improve his condition. But a person whose behavior is bad, as a person who has not a good behavior, he is a mad person. So the Holy Prophet gave us a definition of who is a mad and who is a wise. And as I mentioned before, the Holy Prophet was unique in changing the norms of the society. He used to change the norms that were prevalent in his society. Many things were prevailing in his society, and he slowly and gradually changed those norms and those etiquettes. And one of the etiquettes were the concepts that were prevailing there. And one of the concepts was the concept of wise and mad. The Holy Prophet told us who is wise and who is mad. And look at this definition, how humanitarian this definition is, how good this definition is. The definition does not rely on any element that is racial, that is discriminatory, and that is not acceptable. The definition depends on something that are very rational and that are very much acceptable. It says, look at your behavior. Your illness is not in your hand. You don't have any control over your illness. Somebody is ill and somebody is well. Somebody is healthy and somebody is not. So illness is not something that lies in your hand. Health is not again something that lies in your hand. Of course, you can do something to improve your health or to maintain your health, but everything is not in your hand. Similarly, illness is not even in your hand. You can visit a physician. You can take medicine, but medicine is not everything. You might take pill very regularly, but its improvement may not be achieved. But your behavior is in your hand. You can behave like a prophet. You can choose the Holy Prophet as your model. You can choose the Holy Imam as your example, and you can follow them up. You can follow their conduct. You can follow their tradition. You can do what they have done in their lives. And therefore, you are free in this regard. And you can choose your model, and you can choose your example. And therefore, you are expected to choose a model that is in your interest, that serves you in the long run. If you follow up the example of the Holy Prophet, of course, you will be prosperous in the long run. You will achieve happiness in the long run, and this will be in your interest. So why don't you follow good examples? Why don't you follow progressive instances and examples? So since your behavior is in your hand, since you have full control over your actions, therefore the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, links madness to something that is optional, and not to something that is beyond your option and beyond your control. And since illness is beyond your control, therefore madness is not linked, according to the Holy Prophet saying, to it. It is linked to your behavior. So the message that we can take from this, and the lesson that we can draw from this, is that we must try to improve our behaviors. We must try to make our behavior standard. There are standards, there are principles. We must try to put these standards into practice. We must try to put these principles into practice. And by doing so, we can improve our ethics and our morals and our actions. And once we are able to improve them, then we will be wise. We will be a good person. And we will be a person who is liked by the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, and by Allah the Almighty. And that is about the definition of a good and a wise person from the perspective of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. Another quality, or another characteristic of this quality, is that being humble, or humbleness, is a very good strategy in life. Of course, there are different strategies, there are different ethics, you can follow different things. There are ethics that are quite secular, there are ethics that are religious, there are ethics that are humanistic, and you can choose between all these ethics. But the best ethics is in Islamic ethics. And one of the best principles in Islamic ethics is the principle of humbleness. If you follow the principle of humbleness in your life, it will be in your advantage. You will be able to gain friends. You will be able to be a popular person in your community, in your family, and even you will be a national figure. But if you do not follow this principle, if you do not pay attention to this principle, of course you will not be a person who is liked by others. You will be isolated. You will be disliked. You will not be appreciated by those who are around you. So if you want to gain popularity, if you want to be loved and liked by others, then follow the strategy and the principle of humbleness. And this is what the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, advises us to do. In a very beautiful saying, he says, Ya Bani Abdul Muttalib, innakum lan tas'un nas bi amwalikum. O children of Abdul Muttalib, you cannot gain the favor of others. You cannot gain popularity through giving your property, because your property is limited. You cannot give something to everyone, because if you spend your wealth so lavishly, sooner or later you will be poor and you will not have anything to spend. You will live from hand to mouth. So this is not a good way to gain popularity through spending, because you do not have infinite property. You do not have unlimited wealth. And since your wealth is limited, and since your property is limited, therefore you are not expected and you are not required to spend very lavishly. So how can we gain popularity? What is the best way for gaining popularity? According to the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, فَأَلْقُوهُمْ بِتَلَاقَةِ الْوَجْهِ. The best way, in the simplest way, is to approach people in a good manner. Do not approach people in a bad manner. Do not misbehave others. Try to behave them in a good way. And if you behave others in a good way, this will provide a very good means for gaining popularity and for gaining the hearts of others. And it is not costly. It is very cheap. It is very much inexpensive. You can do it very easily. وَحُسْنُ الْبِشْرِ. Again, the Holy Prophet emphasizes on good behavior. If you improve your behavior, if you improve your approach towards others, you will be able to gain friends, you will be able to make new fellows, new friends, and that is a very good thing. Of course, each one of us wants to gain friends. Don't you like to have more friends and new friends? Of course, every one of us, male and female, wants to gain new friends and to make new friends. But what is the best way for making new friends? Is the best way spending? Should we spend? Should we give ice cream to others? Should we invite others to our house? Should we make parties and do things like that? Of course, you can do things like that. But these things are very much costly. You cannot afford it. If you are able to afford it for once, you will not be able to repeat it. Your means are limited. So the best way is to change your behavior, to improve your approach and your attitude. And once your attitude is improved, once your behavior is changed into a better one, then of course you will be able to make new friends very easily. And you will not face any problem in this connection. And that's why the Holy Prophet advises the children of Abdul Muttalib to follow this strategy. And this will be responding. Another important uses of humbleness is that it helps us to enter paradise. As I mentioned before, entering paradise is also one of our desires. Each one of us desires to enter paradise, because to live in paradise is something like a dream, like an ideal for each one of us. We want to enter paradise. We offer prayer, we fast, we go on Hajj, and we do different things in order to enter paradise, in order to satisfy God. The Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, says that one of the easy ways of going to paradise is that be humble. If you are humble, and if you are not arrogant, if you are down to earth, then you will be among those who will, inshallah, enter paradise. So why shouldn't we do this? Salasun man atallah biwahidihi biwahidin minhun awjaballahu lahu aljannah. There are three things. If you do any one of them, Allah Ta'ala will help you enter paradise. Al-infaq min iqtar. And one is spending. One is giving charity. If you give charity, that will be very much helpful. وَالْبِشْرُ لِجَمِيعَ الْعَالَمِ. This is important. And to be good towards everyone. And to have a good behavior towards everyone. وَالْإِنصَافُ مِنْ نَفْسِهِ. And of course, to be just is also very much desirable. If you do any one of these three things, you will be entitled, from the viewpoint of the Holy Prophet, to enter paradise. So since it is our desire to enter paradise, then we should try to be humble, and we should try to follow this moral principle. That is all. Thank you very much.
فكن لي فإن لم تعف عن ذنبي فمن لي